Listen, I don't care how the song go. If you see me and you trying to see what's up, do not yell ski ye to me.
Back up on my bullshit, back up on the scene. Done dealing with you, don't know how to deal with me.
Hi friends, it's your girl Sid and welcome back to my channel. It's a weekend vlog. It's Friday, January 12th. Whoa, my bad. It's Friday, January 12th. It's really bad weather right now. I'm not gonna lie, like pouring rain. I didn't do anything all day today, honestly, truly. Right now it is like 10:30. I'm on my way to the uptown area. My friend Maya is in town. I don't know if y'all even have ever met Maya, but Maya's in town. It's our little sister Maddie's birthday, her 21st birthday, so they got a section at Encore. So you know we about to turn up, but funny thing is, I'm fasting right now, so I'm not drinking or smoking hookah. I am there strictly for the vibes, okay? I'm about to head to the uptown area and probably head to Cordell's house to pregame, even though, once again, not pregaming. So yeah, that is my plan for the night. Also, with it being two years of me being in Charlotte, I do have a video uploading. By the time this is uploaded, that video have already been uploaded, but just an update, the, you know, pros and cons of Charlotte, my thoughts, how it's been, all that jazz. So if you are curious about like living in Charlotte in your 20s and how it's been, just check out that last video for me. And let me know if I didn't answer any question you might have, so on and so forth. This intro kind of got long and I didn't want it to be long. So like this video, comment down below any content you want to see from me. And as always, subscribe to my channel so you can stay hip on all the tea. Okay. All right. Talk to you later. You had a great time? You had a good time?
Yeah!
She slept. I'm gonna lock the door.
What you say? Let us in immediately right now. I'm saying, why was I acting like that?
Because you were drunk, heifer.
I gotta get out of town.
Is we legal in a... Michigan now?
Uh-huh. It's been legal in Michigan.
So you got this from a dispensary?
Mm-hmm.
200 milligrams? Oh, hell no. I'm scared.
The whole
of you.
Pack is 200 milligrams. It's only 20.
A 20, 20 per piece, though. That's a lot.
I ate half.
That's a lot.
10 milligrams is a lot.
Maybe me and edibles don't get along.
Them Rice Krispie treats be like 100 or 200.
Exactly.
What a little bleep.
I know. I know.
No, for real, you will be high for like a real long time.
Bro, I'm like, I don't like that. Like,
edibles is like a body high. It's not a,
yeah,
like just a hair high.
And the thing is with edibles, like, this is why I'm like, I just gotta take one and done, because you don't hit, it don't hit you right away like weed do.
Yeah.
Like, child, no, the first time I ever took edibles, I took like some homemade
cookies. I would never eat a homemade edible, because you really can't tell what you're doing. Like, you know, at least at the dispensary, they have to measure it. They have to regulate it. They have to put how much is on there on a pack.
Uh-huh.
At home, you really kind of don't know.
And the thing is, like, so that was the very first time I had edibles. I was at TSU homecoming, and we had, like, cookies. Bro, I was literally in the car crying, like, I don't want to be high anymore. Like, not somebody help me. Like, I don't want to be high.
But you know what? I've never had an experience where I was like that, like, crying. But I did have an experience where I was too high, and I was at Topgolf, and I kept feeling like I was going to fall off the thingy. Platform.
Yeah.
I'm like, I quit. I don't want to play anymore. Like, go ahead. But now I just eat them like, so if I'm at work and I eat an edible, I don't eat it until like 12:30, like 1, because I know I'm going to get sleepy.
Yeah.
So I eat it, I be high for like a little hour, and I drive home and I go to sleep. I'm sleeping great. And I like that edibles don't like kind of impair you, like as far as like you can still drive off an edible.
Because
like it, you can still like focus on the road and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Even though you're not supposed to, but like, I can't believe y'all have Virginia. This was like my favorite ramen place. That was like the best ramen I ever had when
We had two.
I know, it's a bunch. I was looking at that.
I didn't know it was a franchise until I moved here. Because we don't have them up north.
I didn't know that it was a franchise either. Do you vlog every day?
On the weekends. I vlog on the weekends because I feel like that's when my life is more exciting.
Do more stuff.
Yeah, I do more stuff. And then, like, I do, like, standalone videos. So, like, I need to record this video either today or tomorrow that's supposed to go up Monday about, like, my 2 years in Charlotte. Mm. It's crazy. It's been 2 fucking years.
Right.
And, you know, I don't sit down nowhere. So just...
Right. Because you were in Chicago.
I was in Chicago.
Then you went to Atlanta.
No, then I went to Cincinnati.
Then you went to Cincinnati.
Yeah.
Then you went to Atlanta?
I interned in Atlanta, but I ain't later. My mom moved to Atlanta, though.
Right. I remember you were there, though.
Yeah, I was there for internship in college.
Yeah, that's right there.
So now we just gotta fly somewhere to park. Yeah. Oh, we might push you.
That's handicap.
That is.
Oh,
that's
not
that.
Ah, make some noise, y'all. What?
Now, they were all.
It's the side over here.
Yeah.
Shit, yeah. That'd be easier.
I'm a whipper. I do this.
I does this, man.
Can you park here, actually? Well, I'm up there.
It said mobile payment only.
But it say no parking. Oh, that's up there. What does that say? It say no parking anytime.
Oh, it do say the 13th.
That's 13. That's definitely today.
Sure is. It do say that.
Yep, we ain't gonna risk that one.
I'm about to say, Not for some noodles.
Not
for some noodles. Not for some
spaces.
Oodles.
Yeah, I told you I had to break.
I don't like hookah.
Oh, I was not trying to get on the highway. God damn.
How did we do this?
I thought I was going around. Oh, shit. Chad, let me put it back on the GPS. I just fucked us up.
Back on the freeway is called right, is it?
And now I gotta go all the way down to go all the way around.
Dang.
By the amount of miles I just did trying to find this damn ramen spot.
Okay.
I done went all around Charlotte.
For no reason. All because we made a mistake and got on the damn freeway.
Yeah. Now, I'm like, we should have just parked there.
Like, at this point.
But no, we gonna go in this garage real quick. See what they talking about. See, because this other car is parked there. See, because sometimes Charlotte be... Oh, wait. Bitch, we can park right here.
All
right. Look at that. Did all that. It can park right here. Mm-hmm. For the frisky. Well, not for the frisky.
For the cheapski.
We gonna see what they talking
about. Less than $10, ain't that with them...
Girl, we gonna see. Wait, that's a. What's today? Saturday? Yeah, it is Saturday. 4-6.
We ain't gonna be here more than 2 hours.
Hell no. But I just wanna see what they're talking about. Heart Mobile.
Most of these be like, what, $2? That's how it be downtown Detroit. No?
Hell no.
It be like $2.
Oh, it say parking got a lot of this time. I don't see that. That there's not a sign that says that here, so we're just gonna say it's free. But yeah, we're going to Virginia. I'm gonna try Virginia for the first time.
Yummalicious.
Bitch, I got my own fight. Don't need security in the club. All they wolfing on the knee, nigga. I thought you
were. Yeah, this is black on. This location is black on. Mm-hmm.
Thank you. Your wonton roll with the spicy sauce.
Thank you.
For Charlotte. Broccolini, right?
Yes, thank you.
I forgot who got fried onions, but here you go.
Thank you.
Would you like any, I don't know, anything like napkins, sports?
Maybe a couple napkins.
All right, sounds good.
And maybe I do want a portable. I don't know. Yes, I can afford it. Thank you.
A what? Contenter is crazy.
Contenter. If I make it darker.
You make everything dark. I turn my brightness up. I'm like, we just put the
thing. We love it dark.
What's your name?
Shut up! We're gonna have the chicken one on top.
Such a happy girl.
I also got the chicken on top later, spicy. Happy girl, happy girl. Then we got poppers. I think I'm gonna just put some of the spicy sauce on my shit. Wait, actually, let me try it first. The broth?
It's really good. Like, they have a good flavor of the broth. Like, it's so good.
It is good. I do want mine spicy, though. So, we're gonna put some hot sauce in it.
That's probably so horrible.
Oh, wait. What should be eating? Huh? What should be eating?
I don't really know. Me and the keep breathing.
So it's 2:31. After we went to Junior, we went to Target, and Maya's mom picked her up, so she's on her way back home. I just ran to the beauty supply store. I need to try and fix my lace. Yeah, let's go back to the crib, and then I am going to take a quick nap. I think, I don't know what I'm gonna do. Yeah, I'm about to take a nap. I'm not gonna hold y'all. Tonight, I'm going to my homegirl's crib because it's her birthday. She's having like a little shindig. So I'm gonna pull up for that. Also, don't judge how I eat my Snickers. I eat like the chocolate and the nougat at the bottom, and then I eat the nuts at the top. That's how I eat all my candy. Like, I like deconstruct it. Like, Kit Kats, I can't eat in public because I eat the outside chocolate. Now I eat each individual wafer layer. Y'all, I bought this whole freaking apparatus from the TikTok shop to like hang you, like I'm basically like a car mount that hangs from your rear view mirror, and it won't hold my camera. Like, it won't do it. So that was a waste. It was more so, I'm not even upset about the money because I know it was cheap, but I just wasted. Just wasting my time. It's 9:06. My ETA is 9:30. I'm about to head to Size. She's having like a birthday shindig. I'm just discombobulated. I literally was just talking to Maya about how like the liquor store is closed at 9 and didn't think like, oh, let me go grab a bottle earlier. So I'm showing up empty-handed. And if you know me, you know I hate showing up to a birthday anything empty-handed. But I texted her and I was like, hey, just. That's just, you know, like, I owe you a bottle. I owe you a bottle. She said, girl, bye. I'm playing my Wings playlist. I'm playing it all day. Y'all, last night I watched a Lizzie McGuire movie, and like, first of all, do the children nowadays have like shows and like pop stars that they like follow along with? Like, I just feel like the kids nowadays are too grown, and we need to just bring that culture back. Like, even the little pop magazines for kids and like teenagers, I don't think we have those anymore. Like, we don't have tween stores. Like, I've been seeing so many TikToks about Sephora and the 10-year-olds and Sephora buying stuff. Why are you 10 years old and you got Drunk Elephant? I'm 26 and I don't even have Drunk Elephant. Like, it's just shit like that I'm like, bro, these kids don't have role models our age, or like role models that they can look up to that are age appropriate. Like, it just blows my mind. Cause if you would've asked me, I was gonna be the next Raven Baxter. What? Or a Cheetah Girl. Like, me and Kayla just had this conversation. I didn't get my makeup done until I was in high school. And it was for like school dances. And even then, very minimal. And not even all school dances, maybe like one or two. Like prom, I think was my first time. No, I definitely got my makeup done before senior prom. No, maybe. Or maybe like a homecoming. But it was like my mom's friend princess that did my makeup, like, or my mom would do my makeup. Like, I wasn't getting it professionally done. prom, we just had the limo. We wasn't pulling. I didn't have a custom dress or anything. I literally rented my dress from Rent the Runway. I couldn't wear acrylics until I was out of the house. I couldn't wear red nail polish because I was too fast and too grown. Lash extensions weren't a thing. What else? Shit. I didn't get my first sewing until I was a junior in college. And Benny installed it. Like, these kids are too fucking grown. That is crazy. Like, there's no way. I really want my generation, even though I'm not a parent, I want my generation to bring back how we were raised. Like, baby, you want to go through an ugly stage. You really do. I went through my ugly stage in college. So I feel like I hit my ugly stage really late in life. But no, baby, you're not wearing weave at the age of 12. Like, you're not. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. You're not going to have Amiri dreams and denim tears at the age of 14. Like, I'm so sorry. As a matter of fact, you're going to go to a school where we wear uniform. That's the time I'm on. Concord. It's kind of far from where I stay now, but I don't mind traveling for the Lord, you know. On today's agenda, I have church, obviously, and then I have the place at 5:30, which is basically like church part two, but I really enjoy the place. If you're in the Charlotte area and just want a safe space, in a sense, I would recommend the place. I don't really know how to describe it because it really is like another church, just a smaller community. It's a lot more people like our age. A lot of like my peers and friends go. Actually, my friend Trey from, how do I describe Trey? So Trey and I met spring break 2018, he's an alpha. So we basically met their whole line. My line met their whole line, spring break 2018 in Miami. And we really just like, all stayed in touch, but like Trey and I would do like yearly check-ins. Speaking of, I need to call him. But like randomly last January, he like sent it to me because he lives in Connecticut. He sent me the thing. It was like, hey, like this is my pastor. He comes to Charlotte once a month. You should check it out. And I like didn't really think much of it. And then I found out that like a bunch of my friends actually went to it. So I was like, let me check it out. But at that time, I was volunteering at my old church. I was volunteering on Sundays at that time, so I couldn't make it. And then when I stopped volunteering there, I started to go there, and I loved it. So, yeah. But anyway, church, I got the place, and then I'm probably gonna be outside tonight, not gonna lie, to bring in my Founders Day. So, I just left church. Great, great service. We talked about holy habits. He gave us three this week, and the next week he's gonna give us the other three. I need gas, y'all. When I say, like, the line isn't even existing anymore, like, it is blank I am so nervous because I have to sit in traffic leaving church every time, and I sat in traffic coming to church. So I probably got like 5 miles until I run out of gas. I gotta show y'all how long this line is to leave. Like, hold on. Can y'all see it? Like, it literally does not end. If you go past that cart, it's like over that hill. There's still a hill, and then you have to drive a little bit more to get to the light. So all of this is just traffic. And look at how much gas I have, y'all. None. Literally none. Okay, we finally made it to the gas station. I'm about to go in and put gas in my car. But there's a coffee shop somewhere around here. I just looked it up. Does anyone else utilize like their time at the gas station to like clean out their car? I have so many shoes in here. That's my thing. I have shoes. Also, I have this phone mount that was supposed to hang from my thingy, but it doesn't work. I was gonna do it for my camera. It's too big. Also, if you're in the Charlotte area, my church wants us to invite people to come to church starting on February 4th. They're starting their relationship series. So they gave us these cards that say, "Can we talk for a minute?" And then it says, "Join us this February for a 4-week message series on relationships." So if you're single, you got a bae, you got a boo, you got a sneaky, you got a situationship, bring your butt to church and we can talk about it. Close your eyes to get away. Just make my mind and I'll arrange it. Beautiful girl, you're stainless. You'll be fine, I'll be painless. When you gotta ride on Eve for a couple days till Friday, you pray. Right? Yeah, come on now. But when you can fill your tank up and fill up again when you don't have, so all of a sudden you don't pray no more. Right. God says, I need you to practice. I need to make sure that you can see me in the dark. So when the light comes, you won't lose focus.
Yeah.
They were on their way to the promised land. But God did it in a special way. He said, follow the ark.
It is around 7 o'clock, a little after 7, like 7:05. I just left the place. It was a great time, as always, though. I got a lot of B-roll. I didn't really record, like, in the moment. I did get a little bit of Pastor Trevor speaking. But I be trying to be in a word, so I really don't be trying to record, like, a lot while I'm there. But till God and I will go. You go, you, like, socialize a little bit. Then, you know, they'll start the evening out with, like, prayer. They'll have a couple announcements. And then after the announcements, there's usually like some type of icebreaker where people ask questions. Oh, Ralph almost got took out, chow. Oh, this is my turn, chow. Now I'm going the wrong way because I'm focused on somebody else. See, I need to focus on myself. Stay in my lane. Yeah. What was I about to say? Oh, so they'll have like an icebreaker and then they'll do like a musical selection. It's usually like 2 songs and then they'll start the word. And Pastor Trevor will speak. He'll like open the floor for questions, dialogue, things of that nature. And I just really enjoy it. I think church is great. And I love Union. I love that I go there. That's truly like a place that I can see myself going long term. But something about the place, I feel like a lot of people, when they talk about it, they're going to describe it as safe. But if it just feels safe and it feels more like a conversation as opposed to somebody preaching and just speaking over you and so on and so forth. Okay, so just pulled up to Encore. Dinner was nice. We went to steak for a day, but like when I say we barely ate anything. I think we got like sides to share, the bread and a dessert. Like she ordered lamb chops and literally turned around and was like, actually I'm not gonna eat those, like I'm gonna be full. And yeah, so but it was nice to celebrate my girl. There we were going home. I'm still gonna be outside once again sober. This autofocus, is my autofocus not on? Like, what's going on? I think that's better. I feel more focused. But yeah, let's get into the beat. That looks good. I did that, I'm not gonna lie. I did that. And also, side note. I got accepted into LTK, which is a like to know
platform so I can start like uploading my photos on there and uploading things I like, linking them in my link to know, and then possibly getting commission on them. So that's exciting. I'm excited for what this year has in store for me as far as content creation goes. I am struggling with like balancing YouTube, TikTok, and Instagram though, not gonna lie. So we'll see how this all goes, but yeah, we just gotta be more organized with our stuff. It's officially 12/19, and you know what that means. Happy Founders Day to me and mine. Okay? Okay. All I'm drinking is champagne. All you want is the same thing.
Yeah. The 10,000 building, get your ass an apartment, put you inside a G-class, that's just a start. It can plenty things kind of life, but none of them is a thought of it. New piece around my neck.
Bitch, we are five tonight.
Three bottles is crazy.
I love you. I don't know.
No, fuck you. No!
Listen, I don't care how the song go. If you see me and you trying to see what's up, do not yell ski ye to me, because you're not going to get a freaking response.
The fuck?
I'm walking in my car. This man gonna yell ski out his. I keep walking. He like, excuse me. Yeah, I don't got nothing to say to you now because I'm not sexy. Sorry. And then it was like, well, fuck you then. I kept walking. I'm ignoring that. Like, this is why I say my husband is not in the club. Because that work on other people? Please. Not this one, baby. Good morning, happy Monday, and happy Founders Day to all my sorors. I'm currently running late, it's 10 o'clock. I have the Pretty Fit Workout hosted by Lab 29 and Chosen One Training. You see, I got this hat on because baby, this lace is definitely lifted. I was gonna wear the wig band, but my mom was like, I hate when y'all be in the gym wearing a wig band because y'all feel like y'all invisible and nobody sees it, but they see it. Okay, girl, you got me, so let me just throw on this hat.
Send a text to your DM. Early for your fucking nails. Too early for your fucking nails. You and your naughty shoes to wear. So I bought you another pair. Girl, I got you another dress. So bring your ass up them stairs. I buy you shit because you wear. I'm blessed because you know I care. Bitch, you know you love it here.
What's your name?
Sydney.
Sydney, how are you feeling today? How are you feeling about the workout today?
The workout was good. I feel really good.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. I did a lot of coaching, a lot of standing up, and a lot of
signing. I saw you standing up, signing people in, but I didn't see nothing about no coaching.
I did some coaching, you know what I'm saying?
You
too busy
races?
Work. You're too busy working, okay. So that's good. That's good.
We appreciate y'all.
Yeah, for sure.
We got one. Do we let a case?
I'm here.
Fuck
with
no, baby.
Can I ask your name? Do we let a case? I just want to know who hurt them. I'm here with
Jay Horton.
Jay Horton, I have a question for you, real quick.
Oh,
do we let a case?
No.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, you should.
Mark Posey.
I just have one question for you. You ready?
What's up?
Do you let a case?
Of course.
He's capping, y'all. He's like,
oh, the Reds.
I'm here with who?
JD.
JD, I have a question. Do you let a case?
Y'all let a who?
Do you let a case?
Y'all let a case.
Thank you. I'm here with Amelie and Jay. How do y'all think the event was today?
Pretty good. Pretty good.
Pretty
thick.
Pretty good.
Yes, it was a good crowd. Packed house, literally. Parking lot was full.
Just tell us who you are.
Lab 29, baby. Only one and only. One and only. You know what I'm saying? We're all about wellness. We're all about camaraderie. We're all about fitness. We're all about getting it, into it, getting it done, okay?
Happy Valentine's
Day! Okay, really quick, because I know my camera's probably going to die soon. Just left the workout. Well, no, I just left the brunch. The workout was smooth. Taylor, myself, and Saya went to First Watch for brunch, and it was good. But yeah, my camera's definitely about to die. I'm probably just gonna wrap this vlog up here. Thank y'all for tapping in for the weekend. I don't really know what all I got filmed, so we're gonna see it all come together. But as always, make sure you like this video, comment down below any content you want to see from me, and subscribe to my channel. As always, peace, love, and happiness, and I'll chop it up with y'all in the next video. Deuces.